Hello everyone, this is Sudipta from Technical Potpourri and welcome to my new video. So in today's video, I'm going to talk about all the permission and sharing changes that are coming up along with Summer 24 release. So without any further delay, let's see all these enhancements. Before I start, I'd like to let you know, I have a dedicated playlist inside my YouTube channel where I'll be publishing contents about Summer 24 release. So if you go to my YouTube channel and click on this playlist tab, the name of the playlist is Salesforce Summer 24 Release. Now you can subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that every time I upload a new video, you will be notified. And if you like a video, please hit the like and share the video with your friends, with your colleagues. If you have any comment, any feedback, please put that comment in the comment section of this video. Your subscription really motivates me to bring more contents in my YouTube channel. So without wasting any more time, let's jump to our Summer 24 org and see all these powerful enhancements. Let's talk about how can I get the user's permission and access summary. So for that, I'm in my Salesforce org and let's go to the setup section. And in the setup section, if I type user and open the list of users, from here, if I open any user, I will find under the user record, there is a button called view summary. Clicking on that, it will give me all the information about that user, like what is the user permission, object level permission, field level permission. And in the field level permission, there is an object name. I can change the object, for example, account to case, and it will give me the case field level permission. Any custom permission, public group where the user is part of, and any queue where the user is part of. So this will give you an overall view of the what is going on with the user. Let's talk about if I have a public group, how can I know where my public group is being used? So for that, yeah, let's type group and let's go to the public group. Here I have two groups, Hello Canada and Hello World. So let's open Hello Canada. And here I'll find an option called View Summary. Clicking on that, it will tell me if my group is being used in any owner-based sharing rule or any criteria-based sharing rule, if my group is being used in any reports and dashboard folders, included in any other public group or included in any other list views. Okay, let's talk about what is being enabled in permission set and public permission set groups. It became generally available in Summer 24 and it's one of my favorite features from Summer 24. So now if I go to any permission sets, let's open HTTP callout and click on view summary. It will tell me what are the related permission set groups where this permission set is part of. User permission, object level permission, field level permission, and custom permission. So this is a very powerful feature which gives you a high level overview of what's going on with the permission set. Similar way, if you go to the permission set group, it will tell you what are the different permissions are being part of your permission set group. On top of that, it will tell you user permission, object permission, field permission, and the custom permission. So these are very powerful features which will give you a overall view of what's going on with your permission set and permission set group. I highly recommend everyone to use this feature. Okay, let's talk about how we can automate and migrate user access with user access policies, which this is also became GA in Summer 24 release. Now, if you go to my YouTube channel and go to videos, search for user access, you'll find a video here, automate user to permission set group. This is a video where I have shown you how you can implement this user access policies in your Salesforce org. I highly recommend that you watch this video to understand how you can take advantage of this powerful feature. I'll put the link in the description as well as on the top right corner of this video. But this feature became GA in Summer 24 release. Let's talk about how we can update the order field for existing user access policies. So if you go to Salesforce org and click user access policies, click any, open any existing user access policy, you will find a field called order. And if you click on edit, you can put some numeric values in that order, for example, 1, 2, 3, 4. The intention of this order field is if there is a record which matches multiple user access policies, then which user access policy will be applicable to that record. The way it decided is, you know, if there is a multiple match, the user access policy with the lowest order number will be applied to the record. So that is why this order field is very important. Let's talk about the last one, which is how we can allow users to freeze users and monitor login history. For that, if you go and create a permission set, let me create a permission set here. Let's click on new and let's give a name of this permission set as monitor login history permission and save that. Here, if I type monitor, this is a new permission that is coming up, monitor login history. By default, it will be unchecked. It will be disabled for you, but you can edit that and make this permission enabled By enabling that permission, what will happen, any users with that permission set can freeze other users and also monitor the login history for that user. Before this release, to monitor or freeze any other user, they have to have the manage user permission, which is a broader permission. But after summer 24 release, we'll have this new permission, which we can add to the permission set and then assign that permission set to the particular user to monitor other users' login history or to freeze and unfreeze other users. So I think this is also a very good enhancement. So that's all for today. If you like this video, please hit the like icon and subscribe to my channel so that you came to know about all my upcoming videos. In next couple of days, I'll be publishing more contents about summer 24 release. So it's highly recommended that you please subscribe to my channel. Your subscription really motivates me to bring more contents from Salesforce. Till then, thank you. Bye-bye and stay safe.